Good morning, cadets. Next week you have board exam, and therefore we have started revising the poems, and the first poem which we have taken up for discussion is My Mother at 66. Remember the title, My Mother at 66. Who has written this poem? This poem is written by Kamala Das. So who is the poet? Kamala Das. Well, we have also seen the gist of the poem, but we'll just glance through very rapidly. Remember that this poem is dealing with old age. And with old age, one is quite sure that one may lose one's near and dear ones. And here, the poet feels that she's going to lose her mother soon. So, loss of her mother, death of her mother, death and decay due to aging. So, she's on the verge of death, and she knows that she's going to lose mother. She doesn't want to reveal it to her mother. But when she looks at her, very pale and colorless, ashen-like dead body, she knows that she's going to die sooner. Okay, so let's discuss about this particular poem. Let's go a little bit in detail of this poem. Okay, so let's have the revision of this poem. Let's go to the gist of this poem. The poet is driving from a parent's home to Kochi by car. So what is she doing? She's driving a car. And who is there by her side? Her mother is there by her side. So she's sitting by her side. What is she doing? She's dozing. Dozing means she's sleeping. Her mouth is open. She's looking quite pale, colorless, and she is quite weak, frail-like. So here she's on the verge of death. When poet looks at her, she feels a lot of agony, so she feels kind of pain because she soon realizes that death is going to take her away. She's going to lose her mother. And then she wants to divert her mind. And in order to divert her mind, what does she do? She looks outside. And she looks at the trees which are sprinting. When you are there in the car, or if you are there in the bus, you'll find the trees are moving, going past. Trees are moving very fast, or they are going past. As you are going ahead, they are going behind. So that's what you feel when you look outside. And she sees happy children coming out of their house, bursting out of their house. So very playful mood. So youth and childhood, how we spend the days. So she thinks about those days. And after the security check, when they are there at the airport, she's going to leave her mother. And then when she looks at her mother, mother's face is quite pale, colorless. She knows that, yes, she's going to lose her mother, her loss. That's a childhood fear. So death and decay and loss of her mother, or death of her mother. The poet has always had a very intimate and close relationship with her mother. And the familiar ache is of ache of loss of her mother or death of her mother. So the poet, while leaving, what does she do? She reassures her mother. And what does she do? She smiles. She keeps on smiling. And she just says, "See you, Amma, soon. Soon, let's meet again." Okay, so let's go to those questions which we have See, Nestor, we have seen three questions yesterday. So, what do the parting words of the poet signify? The parting words, what are the parting words? See you soon, Amma. And what do they signify? And then, what does she do? She just smiles. So, those parting words, they express what? They reflect dilemma and confusion that the poet has, or the poet has a fear that she is going to lose her mother. So, the fear of that. So here both parting words and smile, they are in order to give a comfort to her mother. Okay, let's go to the next question. We'll just glance through these questions. So what are the kinds of pain and fear that the poet feels? And the fear is of loss of her mother, separation from her mother, or as she is on the verge of death. Okay, so the familiar ache is that she is going to lose her mother. That is a familiar ache. Okay. So let's go to the next question is what? Why are the young trees described as sprinting and merry children peeling? So they are reflecting, they are actually referring to the different stages of life. So young trees sprinting, that is referring to youth, when we are full of energy, and merry children peeling, that is referring to what? Childhood, when we are in a playful mood. So that they are the symbols of what? Energy, vitality, movement, cheerfulness, joyousness. And in order to contrast here, what is the contrast here? The mother appearing quite pale, inactive, spiritless, dying in a pathetic condition. And in order to contrast that, the poet describes trees and merry children, happy children. Okay. So these are the images in order to understand the process of aging and decay. Okay. So the next question is about the simile which has been there. It's a late winter's moon, as a late winter's moon. So I looked again at her wan, pale. She was looking very pale, wan, ashen-like, as a late winter's moon, dull, very dull. Late winter's moon, how's it? It's quite dull. It's not bright, it's quite dull. It appears quite dull, and similar way her face appears. So there's a comparison of mother's face with winter, late winter's moon. Okay. So it is to convey the idea of the mother's aging. So mother's aging and decay. So the analogy, the reference or the comparison is from seasonal changes. Okay. The similarity is from the kind of changes that take place in the season. Okay, the late winter's moon appears quite pale and its brightness is lost there. So likewise, the old mother is in declining health and she appears quite pale, okay, and energyless. So let's go to the next question now. Question number 5. What does a poet notice about a mother while traveling in the car? The poet notices that her aged, ill, decaying mother is dozing. What is she doing? She is dozing. She is sleeping. Where is she sleeping? She is sleeping by the side of the poet in the car. So the poet is driving the car and she notices that her aged mother, what is her age? 66. So her aged mother is quite ill and she is sleeping. And she appears quite pale. Okay. There's an expression of pain on a pale face. So she appears quite pale, maybe due to her worries and anxieties. Yes, and she's on the verge of death. So the pathetic plight of her mother triggers off the poet's fear about losing her mother. And what is the fear? That she may lose her mother. So what thought does Kamala Das put away while traveling with her mother in a car? So the thought that has come in her mind, that she's going to lose her mother. The pale, decaying plight of the mother drives the biting ache, pain and guilty feeling in the poet, that the poet could not care her mother. She would die soon. So the thought that has come in her mind is that her mother is going to die soon. And she wants to put away that thought. She forcibly pushes the thought away as she is quite helpless to overcome the reality, which is quite sickening and dreadful. Dreadful is quite fearful. Okay. So let's look at some of the questions that may appear here, and you can just try these questions. What does Kamala Das see looking out of the car window? All these questions are quite simple, simple questions also. So what does Kamala Das see looking out of the car window? Yes, you can think over that. Trees and merry children, what trees are doing, sprinting, merry children spilling out of their homes. So childhood, youth, very symbolic, okay. So you can answer this question. How does the poet describe the old age of her mother? So how she appearing, her appearance, okay, old age of her mother. She looks quite pale. Yes, she looks ashen like. Yes, so her appearance you have to write here. So the poet, and how she appears quite dull, okay, on the verge of death. So what do this, and what is she doing? She's dozing there. What do the sprinting tree and merry children spilling stand for? So sprinting tree, it refers to what? It refers to youth, when we are full of energy, and merry children spilling. So they, it refers to vitality. Both they are referring to vitality and energy. So how are these images significant in the poem? So how, because when you are quite young and when you are a child, at that time you are full of energy. But in old age, you lost that energy. Okay, so here the images. So there is an imagery that is being used here. What childhood fear is a poet talking about? What is that childhood fear? Childhood fear of loss of her mother, or separation from her mother, loss of her mother, or death of her mother. And why is called a childhood fear? So she had cherished that fear, or she had that fear when she was a child. How does childhood fear affect the, okay, similar kind of this one, affect the poet throughout her life? Okay, so how that fear has affected, probably she has always felt that she might lose her mother at any time. How does Kamala Das bid farewell to her mother? What does she do? She says, see you Amma soon, and she keeps on smiling again and again. Okay, so that is how she bids farewell to her mother. What does that show about her mental state? She wants to comfort her, give a comfort to her mother that nothing is going to happen and you'll become all right. So what thoughts do you think disturbed Kamala Das at the airport? So what thought? The thought of loss of her mother. Yes. Why could not the poet express her sincere thoughts to her mother at the airport? How can she tell her mother that she's going to die? So naturally, she couldn't express because she was on the verge of death. What is the theme of the poem? The theme of the poem is aging, the process of aging, and death is inevitable, isn't it? So the process of aging, it is a referring to that. So it's quite natural process, aging. So the poem refers to the theme of aging and death. The fear and anxiety of the poet is universal than personal. Yes, it can happen to anybody. So anybody's mother, father. So this is quite universal. It doesn't apply only to the poet. It is not that others' mothers won't die. Yes. So do it. So your personal response question. So you feel whether it's universal appeal or universal application is there. That's what you have to think about that. Yes, very easily you can give answer to that. Yes, it's up. Yes, it is universally applicable. This poem is unpunctuated and in one loosely held sentence. Yes, the entire poem is written in one sentence. What does implications does it suggest about the meaning of the poem? So it wants to convey one particular idea. The idea of what? It wants to convey one particular idea. And what is that idea? The idea is that the death is inevitable. And it's quite natural process that one will be aged, or aging is the natural process. Okay. What does the title My Mother at 66 signify? So the poem is about mother who is quite old. Okay. And who is on the verge of death, and one may lose. So here you can give explanation how the poet feels. Okay. So let's go to some of those questions quite often appears in the exam. which will be there on the stanza. So let's see how you can give answer for these questions. Okay. So I looked again at her wan, pale as a late winter's moon. Remember here, late winter's moon. That is the example of simile. Okay. It's compared. Her face is compared to what? Late winter's moon. So mother's face is compared to late winter's moon when the moon is quite dull and it has lost its shine. Shin, you can say shin or shine or brightness. And fail that old formula, very important stanza this. What was her old formula ache, or what was childhood fear? What was childhood fear? Familiar ache, that loss of her mother, or separation from her, loss and separation from her mother, or death of mother. But all I said was, see you soon, Amma. And all I did was smile and smile and smile. Okay, so name the poem and the poet that is asked here. So what is the title of the poem? My Mother at 66. And who is the poet? Kamala Das. Remember that. Who looked pale and wan and why? Who looked pale and wan? Who looked? Poet's mother looked. Who looked? Poet's mother looked pale and wan. Why? Because she was quite old and she was on the verge of death. What was the speaker's formulaic? Speaker's formulaic was separation and loss of a mother, or loss and or death of the mother. You can write any of those answers. Those are acceptable. Loss of a mother or death of a mother. Explain as a late winter's moon. I already given explanation about late winter's moon. So her face, how it appears? It appears like the moon, which is there in the late winter. Okay, let's go to a similar kind of poem question, which is extract based question. So now in this new format, these questions are quite important, and these are all extract based questions. So let's see this particular question, which is on extract based. Okay, so let's see here. But after the airport security check, standing a few yards away, I looked again at her wan, pale as a late winter's moon. Okay, now this is very important. After the airport security check, the airport security got over. What has happened? Poet was driving her mother away to the airport, and they come to the airport. The check gets over, security check gets over, and then she looks at her mother. How does she appear? She appears quite dull, wan, colorless, pale. And she appears like a late winter's moon. Now, late winter's moon, she appears like late winter. Again, simile which is there. Identify the figure of speech in the above stanza and explain. So, identify the figure of speech. Which figure of speech is there? That is simile. So, for her face is compared, mother's face is compared to late winter's moon. Okay. So, which this one is there? That's a simile. Comment on the significance of again. She happened to see when she was dozing, when she was there in the car, she had seen her mother was on the verge of death. She wanted to put that thought away. And in order to put thought away, what does she do? She looks outside. But again, that thought has come to her mind now when she looks at her. And what is that? That her mother has lost all that sheen, all that bright, yes, brightness or vitality or energy in her life. She is on the verge of death, so she is bound to die. So who is her and how does her appear now? Who is her? Her here, poet's mother. And how does her appear now? She appears quite pale and ashen like. When she appears quite ashen like, and identify the figure of speech that already we have seen. What, which figure of speech is it? That is simile, and you have to explain. Yes, during the late winter, what? The moon loses its brightness. It appears quite dull. And similar way, the mother's face appeared quite dull, colorless, and pale. Thank you. Goodbye.